I know it comes as a surprise, but I do love to shower, and I think there are many out there who enjoy that too. The only problem is that I often forget time and space while showering, which results in an excessive water wastage, which in the long run is neither good for the environment nor my wallet. So I want to cut down on shower time. And what better way to do so than being constantly exposed to how expensive this hobby is? And that is exactly why I came up with this contraption here, which I can easily add to my shower faucet so that it can track how much water I'm using daily and publish this data online so that I can check on it everywhere in the world. And spoiler warning, this project was not super simple to pull off. But in hindsight, it was definitely worth it because you can easily adapt it for your own home. And even after using it only for a short amount of time, I have to say that it truly does make a difference just knowing how much water I'm using daily. So without further ado, let's get started. This video is sponsored by Prusa 3D printers. More about them later during the video. To start things off, I got myself the heart of this project, which is this water flow sensor that you can get for pretty cheap from the internet. Mine comes with male 1/2-inch threads, which will later fit my faucets. Now all the sensor basically does is spinning a small wheel on its inside when water is flowing through it. The more water flows, the faster the wheel spins. And since the wheel is carrying a small magnet that passes a Hall effect sensor every rotation, we should be able to get an electrical square wave signal out of the sensor that tells us how often the wheel completed one rotation. So let's hook up the red wire to 5 volts, black to ground, and the yellow data wire to my oscilloscope, and let's get spinning. As you can see, we truly get the square wave I was talking about. And what we could do now for our water measurements is simply counting the amount of pulses and converting this pulse value into a liter value through the help of a relation factor. But weirdly enough, this pulse liter factor was nowhere to be found on the seller's website. So I more or less was forced to determine this value experimental, by firstly creating a small Arduino circuit which can measure and display the amount of pulses the sensor spits out, which was super easy to pull off with just a handful of code lines. After that was done, I utilized lots of sealant tape and a 1/2-inch female thread adapter to attach the sensor to my bathtub faucets. And as soon as everything was successfully wired up, I tested how much pulses it requires to get exactly 1 liter of water from the faucets. And at this point, I discovered something not so good. As you can see, when using a low water pressure, the sensor records a lot less pulses in comparison to when using a higher water pressure, even though both times I was measuring out 1 liter of water. So it seems like such inaccuracies do come with such cheap sensors. And what I decided at this point was simulating the water pressure I use in my shower and determine the pulse liter factor for that, which in my case was on average 660 pulses per liter. With this value in mind, we can alter the code a bit to already create the first prototype of the system, which looks something like this and works just fine. And in case you're wondering, I got the price per liter of water from my local water distributor, which in my case is around 0.0039 euro per liter. Okay, now at this point, the biggest question for me was how to power the electronics in my shower, which is probably the most difficult place for something like this, because you can certainly not use mains voltage in there, and a 5 volt power supply with wire is also not recommended. No, I had to settle with a battery solution, and since they all come with a limited capacity, I also had to think about saving power for the system to guarantee a long runtime. And my solution for that was this additional metal tube that I can just add in series to my water flow sensor. All it does is electrically connecting its two output wires to one another when water is flowing, meaning this is just a water activated switch. It is mandatory though, because with it I can turn on the microcontroller system when I'm actually showering and then automatically let it turn off by itself with a delay as soon as no more water is flowing. But in order to achieve that, I needed an additional set-reset latch circuit, about which I told you all about in my latest electronics basics video. So after building one up on a piece of perf board, of course with the help of a logic level p-channel MOSFET, since it needs to be able to work even with a low battery voltage, it seems like the circuit works just fine and, as expected, draws absolutely no current when the circuit is turned off. Perfect. That means it was time to add a pre-made charge and protect board to the battery, adjust a small boost converter so that it outputs 5 volts for all of the components, and ultimately connect all these so far shown components together like here in the schematic. By the way, I'm using an additional input of the Arduino to detect if water is still flowing, and another pin as an output to turn everything off through the reset pin. I of course had to implement those changes in the codes before I could do one last final dry test and one wet test in the bathroom, which both worked perfectly fine. Sadly though, I had to tear this functioning Arduino system apart, since I needed to switch to an ESP microcontroller, because it not only features Wi-Fi, but is also compatible with the Home Assistant environment that I want to use for the online functionality and about which I told you all about in a previous video. All in all, it was pretty much the same circuit as before, with the only differences that there was no longer a display, there were voltage dividers because the ESP can only handle 3.3 volts, and I also threw in a power status LED for some good luck. And as you can see, the ESP system does seem to work perfectly fine as well. And do not worry, I will tell you all about the Home Assistant programming in a minute. But before that, let's have a look at the very important enclosure for this project, that I designed in Fusion 360. The special part here was to make the inside waterproof, for which I designed this groove, in which I later glued a 5mm thick rubber-like string. But before I could test that, I of course had to print my designed models with my Prusa 3D printer, whose manufacturer are sponsoring this video. So let me tell you that if you're on the market for a 3D printer, I would highly recommend getting such a Prusa i3 Mark 3S Plus. Simply put, it is a workhorse, which after over 4 years of usage still works perfectly fine, and is truly reliable, which is most important for me. And you can find my enclosure files on printables.com, the new go-to site for 3D printable models run by Prusa, but they welcome all users no matter what machine you have. So make sure to check out the video description to learn more about Prusa and also get all the project information there. And with that being said, my enclosure was successfully printed and assembled, and by forcing the two halves together with the help of bolts and nuts, I hoped that the insides would stay dry in the shower. And after testing that out, it seems like my idea was a big success. So I hot glued the status LED inside the enclosure and started nesting the rest of the electronics inside there as well, while occasionally using a bit of hot glue. And after creating another hole for the water flow wires and hooking those up, it seems like everything was ready for the final tests. But before that, let's quickly go through the Home Assistant part, so that you can get an idea of how much I suffered there. Now, uploading the special ESP firmware was no problem, as well as defining all the mandatory pins with their jobs, but it was certainly not easily possible to program the required turn-off logic. To do that, I actually had to create an automation in Home Assistant, which, as you can see, is pretty self-explanatory, but not my favorite way to do things. And it was also frustrating to get the configuration file right, so that it tracks and calculates the hourly and daily water usage and costs. But worst of all, I had to awkwardly install the Home Assistant Community Store, only to get one plugin that can create decent graphs, because Home Assistant alone does not offer such a feature. Thankfully though, everything worked out somehow in the end. And you can of course download all my created Home Assistant files to make your life easier. And with my rant completed, it was time for the final installation in my shower and taking this thing for a test ride. And as you can see, it seems to work just fine by not only telling me how much water I used hourly, but also daily for a period of 7 days. So even though I was not able to add this system to my main water pipes how I initially planned it, because I'm certainly not allowed to do that, I am still pretty happy with the end results. Of course, there's lots of room for improvements, but I still hope you enjoyed this project and maybe learned something new. If so, consider supporting me through Patreon to keep the show going. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!